picked up some fish in this area. It's more movement inside, huh? And the other dog, mm-hmm. for sure. Make a little lift helps you here. Feel it? Yeah? It's getting a little bit better here from the connectivity, yeah? And this small chest. Yeah. That could happen. It's not always like in the books. There's some little variances, yeah? Okay. And now try to get back this, you see the belt. Try to get back to 5 chamber, that means you turn to 10. Yes, perfect. This is one possibility, and you see the atrium gets a little bit smaller now here. So if you see that, you see it disappears, so lift a little bit. Okay. You see there's the papillary muscle. So we are looking too much cloudy now. So, try to get the window back, and then we start again. Yes, the one last window. So, and now turn to 10. So, and now we see it did not work. So, we have to look more cranial, or we have to change the intercostal issues, yeah? But it's not like you want to have, yeah? So, do new, fresh, close to the, yes, oops. Next time you will not be a big dog, but all the very kind one. Okay, super. Here's our order. We start from this picture, yeah? The only thing you have to do now is to look caudal in the intercostal space. She disappears. Yeah? We make it longer, so that means we have to turn the transducer to 11, so counterclockwise. Stop. Yeah? You see? Mm-hmm. Try to turn more, then you will see it gets smaller again. Yeah? Okay, turn it back and come a little bit to the sternum. And maybe intercostal room. Yes, that's it. It's a very cramped window. Yeah? Very good. That's the window. And these tiny little intercostal spaces, sometimes you don't feel that you jump. Yeah? Okay, nice. This is a beautiful window. Yeah? And you, that's a nice, very good approach. Okay, now just look intercostal a little bit cranial. She doesn't want to do it like that, so look caudal back again. Stop. Now you turn to 12 o'clock, that's why it's disappearing. Turn to 11. Yeah, it's back. And now turn a little bit more counterclockwise to see the aorta. More. She's coming here. Here. See that? But we are still one intercostal room backwards because now we see it here closer. So go one more cranial. Just try it and look how. A little bit away from sternum. Yes. Super. We try to get this look a little bit powder. Yes. This is the real cranial. You see it? And you see, even in a small duct like that, it could be that you have to be flexible with the intercostal spaces, yeah? And for sure, it's not so easy to hold it like in the dog before, so she has to really do something. Yeah, it's nice, huh? And look at your hand. Do you see it? This is a typical handhold for the very cranial, hard to scan. Yeah, very good. It's really like this, because you are very cranial, you have to look back to the heart. Mm-hmm. Yeah, perfect. Okay, this is unstable because of
stress.
That's not a good idea. Then we have to remove the animal a little bit backwards, yeah? That would be nice, thank you. That is the typical situation, especially when the owner is at the front, then it's always like that if they go in this direction, yeah? Okay, the only thing you have to do now is you have to turn the transducer. Yes, that's it. You see that? Because if not, this is disappearing, yeah? If you turn too much to 12 or something like that, then the edge room is completely disappearing, yeah? Good. Okay, now turn from here, stay in the granular window and turn in 90 degrees counterclockwise. Help yourself with the arm. Yeah, now let it go down, thank you. Very nice to see. In between you went into an excellent, nice window.
Yeah,
but this is so tiny. Yes, yes, yes. But that is sometimes like that. For sure, but she does very well. It's a complete different situation, and that's why I tell you, if you have an animal which is easy to scan, use it for your expertise, yeah? Very nice, you did that good. Coming a little bit to the sternum to see the apex back again and so on. And now you turn back. Hold the hand in the same position, in the same angle, and everything, very good. Super, hold it. Super nice. Super nice. Yeah, it's very sternal now, but it isn't this dog like that. Yeah. Very nice picture. Do you see the cranny information of the muscle? Nice, beautiful. And then hold it like that. Just start lifting. Yes, super. Centralis is going, aorta is coming. Super. Aorta. If you get lost and you have this animal swing it like that, you freeze and you go.
Yeah.
And then we see, oh, does it, is enough or do I have to do it again? Yeah? Now we're training, so we do it again. This is a nice window there, yeah? You see, this is a little bit too much turning. Okay, perfect. Nice. And here it's always a good thing to see if we are concentric, because if we lifting up and we see the sternum of the core, you see they were earlier than here. Then it's a little bit too much turning, turn 1 degree clockwise. Yes, perfect. And then lift up again.
And when you say lift up, do you mean push or?
No. You stay like that,
yeah.
And this is dropping,
yeah.
And this is lifting.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Good, beautiful. Yeah, you see it's better?
Mm.
So turn 1 degree clockwise. Super, and do it again. It's getting better and better, you see that? Now they're coming at the same time.
Mm.
Yeah, and then lift up more. That means you are like this, and you do like this. I do too much now, yeah? But now, yes, nice. Super, you fend in the heart, upon, so you do it like that, yeah? Very nice picture, super nice. I didn't push here, huh? It doesn't matter, it's nice. So, lift a little bit more. Yes, abdominalis is coming, that's normal, yeah? Because we are now focusing on this side, yeah? Super, you see the valve here, so that's nice. You are in the same height, because these bows are in the same height when you are concentric. So lift a little bit more. Nice, yeah. And the aorta is here from the left side, left atrium. So that's okay. Yes, from here, stay like this and lift again. Yeah. So dog like that, small doggy like that. Yeah, this is always a really, especially when you're training, very good. And then if you lift a little bit more, the pulmonalis is coming a little bit better in the view. You see that?
Mm.
But it's very tiny, very, here's the branches.
Mm.
And The rest is the lung. That could be that you can avoid it in coming 1 millimeter more to the sternum. Yes. And then lifting. Yes. Very good, very good, very good, very good. Yeah. Yeah, this is just because the panting now. For sure. Stay where you are. Look more calmly, please. In the inner person's face, because the heart runs away. So, you see that this is now too sternal for a normal concentric view here, but it's the position for the pulmonals. And so stay like that and lifting. More lifting, look at this. Lifting, lifting. Pulmonals, lifting. More lifting. More, more. Nice. Nice. Doesn't matter. We are here to train, so if we lose contact, we get it back. That's then the millimeters of not getting out of this. Yeah, this is just how can I say? This is this.